Welcome to the Haenel Modus 600RT Speedlight. In this video, I'm going to speak about the Custom Functions menu. If you press and hold Function button 1 for 3 seconds, then you're brought into the Custom Functions menu. These are various parameters which you can set for how the Speedlight will behave across all of its different operating modes. On the top right corner, you can see that it's running version 1.3 of the firmware. The first option which I have available to me is meters or feet. In its normal display, the Modus has a scale on the bottom which shows the effective flash range in any given setup. The scale at the moment is graduated in meters, but if I want, I could switch that to feet by pressing the set button, and one rotation of the dial brings me to feet. Normally I would use meters, so I set it back to that. I press set button again to lock my selection. If I scroll down one using the dial, the next item I can set is APO, automatic power off. This has two possibilities, on and off. If it's set to on, then the Modus 600RT will automatically power itself down into sleep mode if it hasn't been used for 90 seconds. If it's set to off, then the automatic power sleep function is disabled and the Modus will keep itself switched on permanently. I'm going to set that to on again. Next function down is FEBACL. This stands for Flash Exposure Bracketing Automatic Cancel. Now, first thing to bear in mind here is this function is not available in the Nikon version of the Speedlight because it doesn't apply. I'm using the Canon version here as an example, so this will not be in the Nikon version. I'll speak in some more detail in another video about flash exposure bracketing, but for the moment what we can say is that if this is set to on, then after you have taken your 3 flash exposure bracketed shots, the Modus 600RT will switch back out of flash exposure bracketing mode into its normal mode. On the other hand, if I set FEBACL to off, then the Modus will stay in flash exposure bracketed mode until I switch it back out of that mode manually. The next option is FEB, and again, bear in mind, this doesn't apply to the Nikon version. FEB allows me to decide the order in which the flash exposure bracketed shots are taken. At the moment, it's set to 0, minus, and plus. So the first shot will be taken with the correct exposure. The next shot will be taken slightly underexposed. And the third shot will be taken a little overexposed. The amount of under and overexposure, you will decide yourself using the Modus controls. So with this function, I can change the order in which the shots will be taken from underexposed, correct exposed, slightly overexposed, or, as we had it earlier, correct exposure, underexposure, overexposure. Next we have AF. This has two possibilities, AF on and AF off. And this is the focus assist beam. If you're shooting in low light conditions, then the Modus can send out a little beam of light to illustrate the subject and shine on it so that the camera finds it easier to achieve autofocus. If it's set to on, then the AF light will be switched on as required. If it's set to off, then the focus assist beam function is permanently switched off. Next parameter is SV APOT, which stands for Slave Automatic Power Off Time. Earlier, we spoke about APO, automatic power off. This applies when the modus is sitting on the camera hot shoe. SVAPOT applies when the modus is an off-camera slave flash gun. There are two options here again, 60 minutes and 30 minutes. So these are the time values after which the slave will go into sleep mode if it hasn't been used for 60 minutes or 30 minutes as you have selected. Next, we have beep. If this is set to on, then you will see on the main screen for the modus, a little loudspeaker symbol will switch on. And in this case, the modus 600RT will give a little audible beep every time it's ready to fire again. So as an example, I'll take a shot here. And you can hear the beep sound almost immediately. This is because, as we spoke about in earlier videos, we're using lithium-ion batteries, which give really quick cycle times and really quick recharge times. So I'm ready to shoot again almost instantaneously with this particular setup for the modus. The next item which I can change is light, and this determines how the backlight for the LCD on the modus will work. I've got three options. I can have it permanently on. I can have it set to a 12-second timeout so that if the modus hasn't been used for 12 seconds, the backlight will shut down. Or I can set it to permanently off. I like to have it on myself, so I'm going to set it back to that. And the final item which I can change is the LCD contrast. This is on a numeric scale, going up to 9 and down to a minimum of 0. I normally set it mid-range at about 5. So now we've seen all the different parameters which can be set using the custom functions menu. And just to bear in mind again that the details of this menu can vary a little from model to model. When you're in the custom functions menu, you also have the option here using the left button to select clear. If you press and hold this for about 3 seconds again, you'll see OK appear quickly on the display. And in this case, you have set all the different functions back to their factory default settings. When you have set everything up as you want it to be, in the CFN menu, press the return button and you're back to the normal modus display. So for more details on how to get the best from your Heindl Modus 600RT, check out some of the other videos in this series.